So for those of you who are new to my channel, I've had a Samsung Galaxy Note 2 for the last 2 years. And while I love the phone, I feel that I'd like to switch back to iOS. Thanks to the iPhone 6, which I've seen both the 6 Plus and the standard sized 6. This is the standard size 6. In person. Particularly with the standard size 6, I feel it's a better fit for me. It fits easier in pockets. Also, with my experience, I've had much more experience with iOS over the years versus Android. This device, is the very first Android device I have ever had. Will it be my last? As far as a phone, at least for now, probably. But I can't say whether or not that's going to be permanent. I might decide to pick up one of these Android laptops. But the reason I'm thinking about moving away from Android as a phone is because over the years, the device has started to act much like a Windows PC. Over time, it just gets bogged down and more sluggish. In fact, the device has gotten to the point where you cannot update it, or I'm sorry, you can't update any apps, and I do have automatic updating turned on, but when it goes to do that, even with just one app, it basically slows to a complete crawl. Now, I'm about to bring up the amount of storage I have on my device, because a lot of you are probably going to say, well, why not just offload some of the stuff that you don't want? And while it is true the bulk of the space is freed up, I still have just under 3 gigabytes, which I feel should be enough to run the operating system smoothly. Apparently it's not. I was talking to a friend of mine who said the only way out of this is to perform a factory reset. You probably noticed on the back of the device here in the picture is the Verizon seal. For those of you who are on T-Mobile, AT&T, regional GSM carriers, or live in other parts of the world where CDMA does not exist, which would actually be 99%, or I should say 90%, excuse me, Verizon does use a SIM, but it's only for data, at least for now. The new iPhone does have the ability to activate the what Verizon is calling in marketing speak XLTE, which is really voice over LTE, which is over time supposed to replace CDMA, which I really hope by within the next 2 years they're supposed to. And by that time, I'm hoping all carriers in the U.S. will have done this. There is one major advantage of GSM carriers, which Verizon does not allow. And that is, and this is the reason why I will not back up or factory reset my device. And that is the fact that contacts cannot be backed up to the SIM card. They can be imported from the SIM and exported to an online service, but they cannot be exported to the SIM card, which, if you ask me, is a major... a major disservice. So I'm definitely looking at getting an iPhone. Over the years, my experience with iOS has been considerably smoother. The only exception being my first generation iPod Touch, which ran into some problems. But I think part of that was because I accidentally dropped it on the concrete a few times. And I did that with my last iPhone, too. And that's where this comes in. It's not out for the iPhone 6 yet, but I'm definitely looking at a life-proof case. Now, a lot of you might be familiar with the OtterBox Defender. This is very similar, except for one advantage that I understand this has over the Defender, and that is this little blue symbol here with the raindrops. The device can be submerged in up to 2 meters of water for up to 1 hour. Obviously, I wouldn't want to go swimming with my phone, but the point is, If there's a sudden downpour of rain, I'll be ready for it. Plus the impact resistance and the dust resistance and whatnot. This is going to be, this case roughly would give it the iPhone, the G-Shock equivalent, if you will, of phones. And, you know, I just think that it'd be a better option for me personally. Furthermore, I did get a chance to try out this.
Voice over on Safari, screenshot 201409. Voice over off.
That voice was Alex. They recently managed to put Alex onto the iPhone. It is an 861 megabyte download, but it is well worth it. Excuse me. Alex is honestly the best voice I would prefer to hear from a screen reader. And just that voice alone, the fact that they managed to get it onto the iPhone, plus my past experience with the iOS devices, and the fact that it's available with 128 gigabytes of built-in storage. I just feel like this is a more natural move for me. So, I just wanted to bring people up to date, and I know that there are Android fanboys, Apple fanboys everywhere. You have to put your fanboyism aside and step back and think about what would be best for you. From a personal level, for me, I think that a standard-sized iPhone 6 with the life-proof case. And for those of you wondering, you're thinking, well, there's no life-proof case for the iPhone 6. There isn't now. And I'm recording this in early October. I won't be getting my device until December, right at Christmas, when my contract is up. And by then, I suspect there will be a whole load of cases available. But no, I think after 2 years of Android, for a cell phone, I do not want to use it again. I don't feel comfortable having to do a factory reset just to get the phone functioning again. And if there's an emergency situation and that phone decides to restart on its own, there was one day when it did that 6 times. You can see where this is going. As somebody who is partially blind and requires a cell phone, not just for convenience, I'm dead serious, requires a cell phone just to get around, to be able to call paratransit, taxi cab, relatives who might be driving me around, anyone, to coordinate, this is a must. So I can't afford to have a device that suddenly goes kaplooey. Now you're probably thinking, well, that could certainly happen with the iPhone. Yes, it could. But in my experience, it's just been a lot easier to work with the iPhone, even when restoring it to factory settings. I just haven't had a more personal experience than I have with iOS. Now, again, I'm not totally giving up on Android because I'm very interested in those Android laptops, and I'd like to see where the market goes with that. And I'm very open to new technologies. But I do think that with the immediate future, I am going to see about going back to iOS. And hopefully by Christmas, iOS 8.1 will be out. Maybe 8.2. What do you guys think? Thank you for watching. Comments are welcome, and have a nice day.